Welcome to the VEX Toss Up referee training videos. I'm Karthik and Rich, chairman of the VEX Robotics Game Design Committee.
And I'm Rich Kressley, education manager for VEX Robotics. We've created this series of training videos for two reasons. One, to help VRC referees prepare for the current game, and two, to give VRC participants a better understanding of the thinking that goes into referee decisions.
We've made 12 short videos on various refereeing topics that you can find right here on our YouTube channel, VEX Robotics TV.
Just a reminder, this is the second year that we've made these videos. Make sure that you're always watching the videos for the current season. This year, it's VEX Toss Up, not the old sack attack videos. Our first episode is an overview of the referee position. We'll talk about what it takes to be a VRC referee and what the key jobs are.
Refereeing is one of the most challenging and rewarding volunteer positions. Just like at sporting events, the referees are there to enforce the rules of the game. However, unlike traditional sporting events, VRC referees actually help the competitors and help them avoid breaking rules.
This is one of the key facets of being a VRC ref. We want referees who liberally warn teams about infractions to help educate the teams along the way.
The key roles of a referee are making sure the field is set up correctly before each match, being cognizant of the schedule and keeping the event running on time, ensuring that teams are placed correctly at the field and prepared to compete. Consistently enforcing the rules of the game as written. Completing and submitting an accurate score sheet at the end of each match.
The key skills of an effective referee are being an effective decision maker, confidently projecting authority, being assertive yet tactful, thorough knowledge of the game rules, strong communication skills, and attention to detail.
Most events will have a head referee. This person is in charge of all refereeing and gameplay at the event. They will have some additional key roles. They have to train all event referees and ensure that they are fully versed in the game rules. They're going to work with the field manager to ensure that matches are proceeding in a timely fashion. They'll work with the lead inspector to ensure that all robots are safe and rule compliant. Of course, they're making all final decisions and rulings, and they're the ones who will be discussing the rulings with the teams.
Through this series of training videos, we'll go over lots of specific situations and events. But before we do that, here are some good general refereeing tips.
The referee's role is to watch for violations and call them. The teams have put a lot of time and effort into the competition, hundreds of hours, if not thousands. Please help them before they violate the rules. It is the philosophy of the VEX Robotics competition to be helpful rather than punitive when it comes to refereeing.
This means warning teams if they are close to being penalized. Often as a referee, you can see when a team is about to violate a rule. Feel free to warn them about their actions. When it comes to issues such as disqualifications, often referees will rule leniently in order to avoid being too harsh. Unfortunately, by not penalizing a team for a rules violation, you wind up directly penalizing their opponents. As unpleasant as it is, if a team violates a rule that is punishable by a DQ, the team must be disqualified. It's the only fair thing to do.
Remember, direct all team questions to the head referee. The head referee should be the only person discussing rulings with the teams. When multiple referees explain rulings directly to the teams, inconsistencies in verbiage can easily arise.
The head referee should explain all controversial rulings and close calls to the teams after all the referees confer separately, as necessary. Handled correctly, this level of communication is a positive experience for all of the teams.
Of course, all referees should have read the VEX toss-up game manual prior to the event. At the event, make sure you have a printed copy for a quick reference.
Or, if you're down with the times, you can download the VEX toss-up mobile app, which allows you to have a searchable version of the manual on your iOS or Android device.
It's important to be down with the times, kids. That's all for this video, but make sure you check out the other chapters on various specific refereeing issues. A good place to continue would be Chapter 2, Before the Match.